Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you how to create a mirrored volume in Windows 11. You create a mirrored volume on your Windows PC so that you can protect your important files. A mirrored volume mirrors the information on one physical hard drive to the other physical hard drive. So if one of the drives fail, your information will still be intact. The only drawback of a mirrored volume or a RAID 1 volume, because they are the same, is that the space that you have will be divided by two. So if you have two physical drives of 1 terabyte each, you're gonna have only 1 terabyte of usable space because the information is mirrored between the two drives. So let me show you how to do this. In this first example, I'm gonna show you how to create a mirrored volume from scratch. And later, I'm gonna show you how to create a mirror for an existing volume. To create a mirror from scratch, you need two empty hard drives that are installed in your PC. So let me show you. In Windows 11, click on the search box and type in Diskman and choose this option here, create and format hard disk partitions. And this is Disk Manager. Let me make it a little bit bigger. So you notice here that I have two drives that are empty. When you open Disk Manager, you're gonna see all the physical disks in your PC. And here I have all these disks. I have two disks, as you see, they are empty. And these two disks are the same size. So it's better to have disks of the same size so that you can benefit from all the space in your volume. So if you right click on any of these two disks, and then here you're gonna see new mirrored volume. New RAID 5 volume is dimmed because for RAID 5 to function, you need three disks, but this is not the purpose of this video. So the purpose of this video is to create RAID 1 volume, which is a new mirrored volume. So click on it, and here click on Next. And here it will select already the disk that you right click on, and it will give you the option to add the disk that is empty. So here, select the disk that is empty, and then click on Add, and it will give you here the maximum amount of space that you can use. You can reduce this space so that you can create the mirrored volume on half of the drives if you want. But in my case, I'm gonna use all the space. So click on Next, and it will ask you to give it a drive letter. D is fine by me. So click on Next. And here, file system, keep it NTFS. Allocation size, default. And the new volume, I'm gonna name it mirrored. And I'm gonna select perform a quick format, and I'm not gonna enable file and folder compression on this volume. So click on Next, and then finish. So if the disks that you selected were basic, as it is in my case here, it will tell you here that it will convert these disks to dynamic disks. So click on Yes here, and the mirrored volume will start to be created. And here it is created, and it is formatting now. When the format finishes, it will open directly the mirrored volume for you. Let me restore it here to show you. So this here is the mirrored volume, and you can find it under my PC. So under this PC, here it is. If you right click on it and choose properties, you're gonna see that the size is one of the two disks. So because it is mirroring the information on both disks. So now that I showed you how to create a mirrored volume from two empty physical drives, I'm gonna show you if you had already a drive in your PC that has information and you want to mirror this drive, how you can add a mirror to the drive. So first you need to install a physical drive in your PC that is empty so that you can mirror the drive that you want to mirror to it. So let me show you how to do this. Always in Disk Manager, here I'm simulating that I have a drive that has important information and I have a drive of the same size that is a physical drive that is empty. So to mirror this drive to this drive, this is what you need to do. You need to right click the drive that you want to mirror, and then you need to click on Add Mirror, and it will detect automatically the drives that are empty and the drives that can be used as a mirror. So here it detected disk 2, so I'm going to select it and then click on Add Mirror. Here you receive the confirmation to continue. Simply click on Yes. And you're gonna notice that the mirror will be established now, and it is resyncing the mirror now. At the end, if you don't need the mirror anymore, you have two options to break it. Either you can break the mirror or remove the mirror. And I'm gonna show you the difference between these two options. So you perform this in Disk Manager. In two words, breaking the mirror means that you remove the link between the two hard drives, and you'll have two hard drives that have the same information once you break the mirror. Removing the mirror, it will remove the drive from the mirror and then it will delete it. So you'll have only one hard drive with the information. So let me show you first how to break the mirror. So this is a mirror here. If I right click on it, you have the option to remove and to break. If you select break mirrored volume, so it will tell you if you break the mirror volume, your data will no longer be fault tolerant. I'm gonna click on yes. And you're gonna notice now that these two drives will be independent. So now we have this drive, which is the drive D, and this drive here is the drive that is no longer associated with the mirror. So you can give it a drive letter. If you right click on it and then click change drive letter and path, let's add a drive letter to it. Let's add E. And I'm gonna show you now that you have the same information in D and then in E. So now these two disks are independent. So now that I showed you how to break the mirror, I'm gonna show you how to remove the mirror. Here I have re-established the mirror just to show you. So you have the mirror drives, which is this one. If you wanna remove the mirror, right click on any one of these two drives and then choose remove mirror. And Disk Manager would ask you which disk you want to remove from the mirror. Disk 0 or disk 2, or of course disks that you establish the mirror on. So for me, I'm gonna remove disk 2. I'm gonna select disk 2 and then I'm gonna click remove mirror. This is a confirmation dialog box. I'm gonna click on yes. And it will completely delete everything on the drive. Of course, your information is still on the disk that you chose to keep, and the other disk is completely deleted. So now you know the difference between breaking the mirror and removing the mirror. And in a future video that I'm gonna make, I'm gonna show you how to recover a mirrored volume in case one of the physical drives fails. So if you wanna see this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. And if you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below and I will be happy to answer them. I'm Eloy and I wanna thank you all for watching. Until next time.